Would everyone able please rise? Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, guests, families, and friends. Welcome to the undergraduate commencement ceremony at the College at Brockport, State University of New York. We're pleased to be able to share this exciting day with you as we confer degrees to over 1,400 undergraduate candidates. Students will be receiving degrees from a wide range of academic programs, including 54 undergraduate majors and teacher certification in 23 areas. Allow me to provide you with some information about the academic garb and ritual you will be witnessing. Today's students and faculty represent the most recent link in a chain of tradition that began more than 800 years ago. The garb they wear is symbolic of the earliest universities and their connection with the church. With the revival of learning in the 12th century, teachers emerged to meet the demand for the new knowledge. A teacher who was successful in attracting and holding students was called a doctor, from the Latin word docere, meaning to teach or a master. Usually, the more elaborate the regalia, the higher the degree. The bachelor's gown worn by students at commencement is the most simple, with no hood and relatively short sleeves. With the master's gown, a small hood may be seen, and longer sleeves, sometimes with slits in the sides for the hands. The doctoral robe is the most ornate, with velvet panels down the front and around the upper back, bell-shaped sleeves, and a larger hood worn on the back. The trim color on the hood denotes the nature of the degree. Most frequently seen on the Brockport faculty is the blue-trimmed hood of the Doctorate of Philosophy. Also present are white for arts, light blue for education, lemon for library science, orange for nursing, teal for public administration, gold for science, and citron for social work. The inside of the hood often has the colors of the wearer's university, usually with one or more brightly colored chevrons against a darker background. You may also spot a bronze and copper medallion signifying the Chancellor's Award, one of the highest honors bestowed by the State University of New York. Since the inception of the award in 1973, more than 194 members of the Brockport's faculty and staff have been recognized for excellence in teaching, scholarship and creative activity, librarianship, faculty classified and professional service. Marshals carry a mace as a symbol of their office and usually lead academic processions. Faculty marshals are usually selected on the basis of seniority or achievement. At Brockport in 2016, the marshals of the commencement procession are the president of the College Senate and selected members of the faculty. Our procession was led by student marshals Dr. Zhi Zhang, Associate Professor of Education and Human Development, and Dr. Angela Tomsell, Associate Professor of History. Following the students and leading our distinguished faculty, our faculty marshals Dr. Alicia Chase, Associate Professor of Art, and Dr. John Kaiser, Associate Professor of Business Administration. Leading the platform party will be the Army ROTC Color Guard unit comprised of students from our Military Science Department. Next will be our Grand Marshal, Sharon Allen, College Senate Representative, followed by our distinguished platform party. Today's platform will include the President of the College of Brockport, Dr. Heidi McPherson, the Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Mary Ellen Zuckerman, our commencement speaker, Mr. Joey Jackson, our own Honorable New York State Senator for Charles Schumer, member of the Brockport Foundation Board, Chair of the College Council, President of the College Senate, the Alumni Association, the Brockport Student Government, our Deans, Associate Provost, Vice Provost, and Vice Presidents. Reading the student names are Dr. Dawn Jones, Associate Professor of Mathematics, and Dr. Linda Cochran, Associate Professor and Chair of Recreation and Leisure Studies. Today's ceremony includes an individual greeting of baccalaureate degree recipients by Dr. McPherson, and Dr. Zuckerman. As students process across the stage later in the ceremony, you will note a small number wearing cords, tassels, or medallions. They are worn proudly by students who have been inducted into one of the many national academic departmental honoraries chartered at the College of Brockport. The honor societies and their respective colors are listed in your program. Colored tassels are worn by students who are graduating with honors for work completed at the College of Brockport. Grade point averages are 3.40 to 3.59 for cum laude, which means with praise in Latin, are wearing green and black tassels. A 3.60 to 3.79 grade point average signifies magna cum laude with great praise, and those students are wearing green and gold tassels. For our highest award, 3.80 to 4.0 for summa cum laude with greatest praise, students have earned a gold tassel. Their names are listed in your program accordingly. Later, as candidates approach the stage, they will receive a diploma cover, a gift from the Alumni Association, the Brockport Student Government, and the College of Brockport. Again, we ask that everyone please remain for the entire ceremony until the students have formally recessed and the exercise concludes. Welcome to the undergraduate commencement ceremony at the College of Brockport, State University of New York.
I hereby declare the 2016 commencement ceremony of the College at Brockport, State University of New York, to be in session. Please remain standing for the singing of the national anthem sung by Brockport senior Ashia Miles.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous flight o'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say
thank you, Ashia. Please be seated. I am Dr. Mary Ellen Zuckerman, Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome our graduates, faculty, staff, college officials, and the many friends and family of our students to this celebration. Today, we celebrate the commencement of our December 2015 and January 2016 graduates, as well as our May and August 2016 degree candidates. Now I have the honor of introducing our platform party. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been made. As I introduce you, please rise and remain standing. Representing the Rochester Education Opportunity Center, Mr. Roosevelt Marius, Executive Director and Dean. Representing the Brockport Foundation, Mrs. Mary Warboys Turner. Representing the Brockport College Council, Ms. Elaine Leschnauer, Mr. Kenneth Pink, and Mr. Scott Turner, Chair. Representing the Brockport College Senate, Dr. Sharon Allen. Members of the college leadership are Dr. James Willis, Vice President for Administration and Finance, Dr. Catherine Wilson, Vice President for Enrollment Management and Student Affairs, Mr. Michael Andriach, Vice President for Advancement, Mr. Dave Mihalyov, Chief Communication Officer, Dr. James Spiller, Assistant Provost for Research and Scholarship and Dean of the Graduate School, Dr. Joes Malikiel, Dean of the School of Science and Mathematics, Dr. Mark Kittleson, Dean of the School of Health and Human Performance, Dr. Darwin Priolo, Dean of the School of the Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences. Dr. Thomas Hernandez, Interim Dean of the School of Education and Human Services. Dr. Susan Stites-Doe, Interim Dean of the School of Business Administration and Economics. Dr. Michael Fox, Vice Provost for Academic Affairs. Representing the Brockport Alumni Association is Mr. Warren Kozareski, President. Representing the Brockport Student Government, Mr. Sean Flynn, President. And our honored guest today is Mr. Joey Jackson, alumnus of the class of 1988 and our 2016 commencement speaker. Let's have a round of applause for our platform party. Please be seated. At this time, it is my privilege to introduce the seventh president of the College at Brockport, State University of New York, Dr. Heidi McPherson.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Welcome. Commencement is my favorite time of the year. It's a day of celebration, both for the students who worked so hard to ensure their chance to walk across the platform today, but also for all of those people who have supported our students, their parents, siblings, partners, friends, and sometimes even their children. For some of our students, this day marks their entry into the world of work. For others, a new stage on their educational journey. But for all of our students, it signals an important and significant change in their lives. They become not our students, but our alumni. It is also a day that those of us who work at the college at Brockport truly see the outcomes of our hard work to mentor and advise students, to engage them, to teach them, and to challenge them. Our world benefits in so many ways from the infusion of capable, highly qualified people, and I am honored and delighted that the college at Brockport has had an important role to play in helping our students pursue their dreams. Standing here today, I can reflect on the tremendous achievements of the students sitting before us. In fact, when I asked my colleagues to provide me with examples of our students' successes, I was rewarded with over 5 pages of single-spaced examples of what our students do. So let me tell you a little bit about the students who are graduating today. They created the Golden Eagle Forecasting to provide timely and local weather forecasts to the athletic department to help schedule competitions. In December 2015, a team of students from the School of Business Administration and Economics competed in the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants competition and emerged as finalists, earning a cash prize of $10,000 for their analysis of a business case. A senior in the Department of History worked to temper the effects of negative social media on campus by working with preventative outreach services to produce a video and a series of events that culminated in the campus-wide effort, Take Back Yik Yak. Our criminal justice students run a career day, and our student teacher education students take part in the Summer Leap Enrichment Program aimed at stemming summer reading loss in elementary school students. Our athletic training students volunteered side by side with orthopedic surgeons, certified athletic trainers, and physical therapists from University Sports Medicine to staff an athletic event for the best 150 athletes in the greater Rochester area. Our athletic teams have had so many successes. This year alone, our gymnastics team placed second in the NCGA National Championships, hosted right here at Brockport, and our women's volleyball team were SUNYAC champions. On top of their athletic accomplishments, our student athletes participate in nearly 50 community service projects every year, including a read alouds program with Rochester Elementary Schools and our partnership with Camp Good Days and the Courage Bowl. Some of the students graduating today started the movement, which has helped our campus engage in an ongoing dialogue about equity, diversity, and inclusion. Our students have studied abroad all over the world, and some attended EuroSim, an annual international intercollegiate simulation of the European Union. EuroSim will be held right here on campus next year. Our students act as peer mentors, resident assistants, and members of task forces, search committees, and other important university committees. They participate in student government. They lead fundraisers and events such as Take Back the Night, Push America, Polar Plunge, and Relay for Life. Our students run the annual leadership conference on campus, which this year had more than 250 students and 30 alumni in attendance. They have, for the second year running, planned a Start a Revolution Women's Leadership Symposium. The Golden Eagle Senior Council is a group of students who coordinate special events for seniors who are graduating to build community and celebrate accomplishments as they prepare to graduate. As you can see, our students contribute to the life of the college in ways too numerous to count. from guiding prospective students around campus during open houses and accepted student days, as well as regular campus tours, to taking part in art exhibits, in theater, in music, and in sporting events. They maintain high academic standards, and many have part-time jobs. Thus, they have learned, sometimes the hard way, about time management, budgeting, prioritizing tasks, and what to do when carefully laid plans go awry. These are the skills, graduates, that will serve you well in the future. All of our students are intensely curious about themselves, their world, and how best they might live in it. They are reflective learners who study with passion the subjects they choose. They make a difference to the world around them. We like to think we make a difference too. Here, I must pay tribute to my colleagues, whose work ensures that there are so many students sitting here today. Our faculty conduct research alongside our students, work to ensure that their lectures are stimulating and provocative, and ensure that they themselves maintain the highest standards of scholarly activity and service to the community. To many of you graduating today, this aspect of our work may not be highly visible, but I can assure you that you have been taught by highly qualified and high-quality faculty. Among the current faculty, there are 18 Fulbright scholars, 8 who have earned distinguished professorships, and 70 who have received the SUNY Chancellor's Award. We believe our students deserve the best that we can provide, and we believe that the experience we offer them should allow them to find the best within themselves. Lastly, I want to thank all those present for the contributions they have made, to the faculty and staff for their continuing hard work, to the families of our students for the trust and energy they show in supporting them through the years of their study, and most importantly, to you, the graduates, who have worked long and hard to get to this point, and while doing so, have given us a great deal of pleasure and not a little privilege. Thank you all, and many congratulations. It's now my pleasure to introduce the Honorable Charles Schumer. As New Yorkers, we are fortunate to have Senator Schumer representing us in the U.S. Senate. We're also gratified that the senator has put Brockport and the Rochester region high on his list of priorities. Senator Schumer continues the fight to make college as affordable as possible for students and parents. He is a familiar face to many on our campus, as he has always made time to attend our commencement ceremonies and speak to our graduates. I've heard so much about the senator's commitment to attending numerous commencement ceremonies across New York State, and I look forward to hearing his inspirational message. I'm pleased to welcome to the College at Brockport, Senator Chuck Schumer.
Well, thank you, President McPherson, and I am as excited as everyone else about your new presidency. We know that you are going to continue the tradition of making sure that the college at Brockport is one of the finest institutions of higher learning, not just in New York State, but in our country. So I'm here to help you in any way I can make that happen. It's also great to have a first time a woman president as head of SUNY, at head of College at Brockport. Now, it's my honor to address the members of the party platform, the family and friends, but most of all, you, the class of 2016, Brockport. Congratulations. Now, first, I'd like to announce my class gift. As you know, it's hard to pay for college. And if you're poor, the federal government helps you out. That's a good thing, but what about the middle class? So, I wrote a law, it's now on the books, that says you or your parents, whoever paid for college, can take as a full tax credit $2,500 off your federal taxes for every year of college to help defray the cost of tuition, provided, in Washington there's always a provided, provided your family income is below $200,000 a year. So, for those of you who make below $200,000, make sure you or mom or dad, whoever paid for college, takes that tax credit. It's new, relatively new. And so a lot of people forgot last year, about a quarter of all people who are entitled forgot to do it. If you've forgotten, you can fill a simple little form with the IRS, you or your parents, and you can get up to 3 years back for that. So that's a check for $7,500, not a bad class gift. Now, what happens if you come from a family that makes above $200,000 a year? God bless you. I'd like to say a word to the moms and dads. I know how you feel, because it was a few short years ago, my wife Iris and I sat where you did, watched our daughter Jessica come up on the stage, and it was one of the greatest days of our lives. And maybe you're like us, you think back to the hard times. We remembered when Jessica was just 5 months old, she had 106.5 fever, we rushed her to the hospital, not sure she would make it. Praise God she did. Then we remembered when we put her on the kindergarten bus for the first time when she was 5. As the bus pulled away, she ran to the back of the bus, tears streaming down her little cheeks. But when the bus came back at 2 o'clock, she bounded off the bus, happy as could be. She said to Iris, who was waiting for her, "Mommy, I came back." When we talked to her that night, we realized what was going on in her little head. She thought that was it, new house, new family, new parents. Then we remember Jessie as a teenager, where she didn't say much to us. And when she did, we couldn't understand a word she said. And then moms, dads, you see your daughters, your sons, come up on the platform, get that diploma, and become an adult before your very eyes. Congratulations to the moms and dads. And finally, one more word of thanks. We're here at Brockport having a great time. But there are young men and women, many from this area, who are in our armed forces. They're overseas in dangerous places like Iraq and Afghanistan. And they are risking their lives for our freedom. Let's have a round of applause to show we're thinking of them. Okay. To this great class, College at Brockport 2016, you know, you're graduating with a whole lot of gifts. I've mentioned two. A great education. You know, only about a third of the people your age get any college degree. And the degree you're getting is a lot better than most, so that gives you a leg up. And of course, you have families, they'll always have your back, they'll be there for you through thick and thin. But there's a third advantage you have that you may not have thought of. You're the first generation to grow up amidst all of this new technology. In 1988, a few years before most of you were born, was the first year the word internet was ever seen in print. There was no Facebook and no Instagram, no Google, no text messaging, no emails, no emojis or hashtags or LOL. In 1994, maybe a few of you were born in that year, the World Wide Web had 13 websites on it. That's it, 13. Now it has 15 billion. That shows you how rapidly technology is changing our lives. And you know, your parents, your teachers, me, the older generation, we try to get used to this technology, but it's hard for us. We're learning it as adults. But you were born into it. Technology is to your generation like water is to a fish. You've been swimming in it your whole lives. And so, the fact that you've gotten a great education here at Brockport, the fact that you have families who are behind you through thick and thin, and the fact that you're the first generation just instinctively familiar with the new technology means one thing. Now is the time, if there ever was one, to figure out what your dream is. Reach high for it. Reach real high. Then reach deep down inside yourself. See what you're made of. See if you can achieve that dream. My advice to the class of 2016 is very simple. Go for it. Now, yeah, that deserves applause, I guess. Now, sometimes you'll make the wrong choice, but if my experience is any indication, you'll pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and move forward. But if you make the right choice, with a lot of hard work, a little luck, and some prayer, your life will be enriched forever. Now, I've learned these lessons myself. When I was seated at college graduation several decades ago, as you are today, I learned that I had just won a scholarship to travel all around the world, all expenses paid, for a whole year. For me, it was the opportunity of a lifetime. I had never been out of the country before. But at the same time, I met a girl and I fell in love. Aww. Well, graduates, I had to decide. Do I go around the world for the whole year on the all-expense-paid scholarship? Or do I stay home with the girl, my first true love? What would you do, class of 2016? Madam President, the class is divided. I stayed home with the girl. No, don't applaud yet. The story continues. That summer, she went on a brief vacation, and I went to the airport to meet her on her return. As soon as she got off the plane, I saw that something was the matter. She dumped me by Labor Day. There I was, no scholarship, no trip around the world, no girl. I said to myself, what a loser you are. You're never gonna make anything of yourself. Give up now. And in fact, I stayed in my house for several months, moped around, feeling sorry for myself. But somehow, I picked myself up, dusted myself off, and moved forward. And a few years later, I found myself seated at graduation once again, this time from law school. But on the way home from law school, I told Mom and Dad I was not gonna join the fancy law firm like we had planned. I told them I loved politics. I told them my dream was to run for public office, even though the chances of winning seemed remote. My parents were shocked. My mother was particularly disappointed. You see, I came from a working class family that struggled to send their son to college and law school. My dad was an exterminator, never went to college, and the law firm was paying $400 a week, more money than my family had ever seen in those days. But my dream was to run for office, and so that fall, at the age of 23 and against very long odds, I ran for the New York State Assembly, and I had three opponents. There was the party machine candidate, there was a neighborhood activist, and then there was my mother, who was telling all her friends not to vote for me. So as she said, I'd get this dumb idea of being a politician out of my big, thick head. Well, graduates, a few years earlier, I sure didn't get that girl, but that November, I won the election. So, to this great class, College at Brockport 2016, remember, you've been given many gifts. Three of them are what I've pointed out. Your great education here at Brockport, families that are always behind you, and an instinctive knowledge of this technology. It is my hope, it is my prayer, and indeed, it's my confidence that you will use those three gifts wisely and well, and you will achieve your dreams. To this great class of 2016, congratulations. Good luck. Godspeed, and don't forget, go for it. I saw you.
Thank you, Senator Schumer. It's a pleasure to have you here on the Brockport campus. It's now my distinct pleasure to introduce this year's undergraduate commencement speaker. Mr. Joey Jackson is a 1988 graduate of our college and has remained close to his alma mater ever since. While at Brockport, Joey took full advantage of what college has to offer. He was a member of the Honors College, directed the student-run Legal Information Service, served as Brockport student government president, interned with the New York State Education Department, as well as with Congressman Charles Rangel through Brockport's Washington Internship Program. After graduating from Hofstra Law School, Joey had a successful career as an assistant district attorney and prosecutor. Mr. Jackson is now with the firm of Kohler and Isaacs, LLP, where he serves as senior trial counsel specializing in criminal defense. Joey is often sought out by media outlets for his legal expertise, appearing on Fox News and MSNBC, amongst others. He is currently employed by CNN and Headline News as a legal analyst. As I mentioned earlier, Joey has stayed connected to Brockport. Last fall, he gave the convocation address to our incoming students, and later in the semester hosted more than 30 students at the CNN studios in New York City. He has also stayed active with the college as a member of the Brockport Alumni Association. I now invite Joey Jackson to come forward and deliver this year's undergraduate ceremony commencement address.
Madam President, distinguished faculty, outstanding administrators, to your lovely family, friends, and of course, to the fabulous graduates of 2016, congratulations to you. Before getting into the heart of my remarks, let me just thank the United States Senator. What an amazing opportunity to hear from the United States Senator who represents us, to be here and to show his love and to show his support for all of you. I think that's an amazing thing, and certainly he deserves a round of applause for that. And to our outstanding president and for her leadership and what she brings to this school that I love, where I found myself and where I grew up, Madam President, President McPherson, God bless you, and may you continue to do fabulous things for this university. And of course, to the faculty, and I have to tell the story. So earlier today, I had the opportunity of seeing one of my professors from yesteryear. And that professor, now Dr. Susan Stites-Doe, taught me in organizational theory. I was a political science major, but it was an elective. And once upon a time, she wrote on a paper of mine, "You're a real go-getter, and I'm a big fan." And you know, that's such a meaningful thing. All of you graduates, as you sit there, you know, sometimes you think, can I get through the hurdle? Can I get through the struggle? Can I move on? Can I make it another day? And then you have faculty like you have at Brockport who provide just that motivation, just that incentive, and just that energy that you need to make it through. And so I'm thankful for that, as I'm sure all of you are thankful for your professors and for your administrators and all the people here who have made your life that much better during your tenure here at Brockport. And so I say thank you. And of course, to your families, as you sit there beaming with pride and beaming with joy over the fabulous accomplishments that these graduates have made, to bring you here today to celebrate them, it's just an amazing feeling. And of course, graduates, obviously you join me in thanking and paying tribute to your beautiful families for all the love, support, and attention. They couldn't do it without you. I'm sure you agree. And now for my message of the day. You know, the fact is that we can think about the future and we could look to predict the future. But the greatest predictor of the future is your creation of that future. And today you sit here having accomplished something so great and looking forward to a future that is full of possibilities. And it's your future to create. And so how do you create it, what do you do, and what do I advise? Well, over the course of time, I've developed a strategy, and I've developed a plan. I call it the 10P philosophy, and I'd like to share it with you. And before getting into number one of the Ps, I would say, You know, there's a major correlation between effort and result. And that correlation goes as follows. The more effort that you put in, the greater result that you achieve. The more time, the more energy, the more focus, the more commitment you bring to what you do, the better you're going to see, the more enhanced you're going to see the end result of your fine work. And so I start with P number one, which is performance. Every single day provides another opportunity for all of us. Every single one of us, as we wake up in the morning, has a renewed opportunity to perform. A renewed opportunity to do our best, to be our best, to try our best. And no one ever, ever, ever will fault you for doing the best you can possibly do at any given time. And so as you go and as you think about what your day is going to be like, perform to the best of your ability. That's all you're ever anticipated to do, expected to do, and that's all you ever need to do. And if anybody ever questions what a beautiful day it is when you get up every morning, if any time you need to think about if any day is a great day, try missing one. And that'll go to show that every day provides us with great fortunes and great opportunities to be the best we possibly can be. And that's your mission and that's your charge. And so we look to step number two of the P's, and that's the possibilities. And as you sit here, graduates, everything is a possibility. And what your obligation is, your charges, your responsibility is to think about those possibilities and to turn what you might think or deem to be impossible to the probable, to turn what is probable into the likely, and to make what's likely to convert that into your reality. Because the fact is that all is possible and anything is made possible through your work, your time, your effort, and your commitment. And there are so many people who love you, who are here for you, and who believe in you. And if you believe in yourself, the possibilities will always be endless. And so we look to item three, which is finding your purpose and your passion. You know, the fact is that there's a pilot light in all of us. And that pilot light ignites us. It wakes us up. It moves us. It brings us. It serves as our mission statement for what we do every single day. And that pilot light and that passion is what all of us, really endeavor to find. And to those of you thinking about this, thinking about that passion and thinking about that pilot light, think about all the time in your life that you're going to spend working. Now, why work for a living when you can do something that you love and that you cherish? And if you have the ability to do something every day that you love, it's not work at all. And so the fact is that we owe it to ourselves to continue our life's mission, to work with our passion, to move forward with our passion, and to be the best we can be while following it. So in essence, we're not working. We're just fulfilling our commitment to do what we love so very much. And so that brings me to item four, which is patience. All of you graduates, as you sit there, you didn't graduate in a day, didn't take you a week, didn't take you a month, didn't take you a year. You're here because of the commitment you made over the course of time. And you knew that eventually you'd get here. But there's a certain amount of patience that's required. The fact is that change is incremental, development is incremental, and sometimes it's slow. But that's okay. It doesn't matter that it takes you an extra week. It doesn't matter it takes you an extra month. It matters that you get there. And when I say you get there, remember this in your patience. The fact is that there's only one time in your life that you can't succeed. And that's the time that you don't enter into the race. Because if you get into the race, the fact is that if you continue to push yourself, prod yourself, and work with yourself, you're gonna get there. Just be patient in doing it. But stay in the race, don't lose focus, and by all accounts and all means, just continue to work hard another day. And so that brings me to item five, which is preparation, planning, and practice. And the point is that The saying is that success comes when preparation meets with opportunity. When preparation meets with opportunity. And the fact is that there will be opportunities, graduates, that you will have throughout your life. And your obligation, your responsibility is to prepare for them. Because when you're prepared to meet challenges, when you're prepared to meet opportunities, you're off to the races. That's where your success comes. And so you, as you prepare, you plan. And as you plan, you execute, but you always practice. And so you think about, what's your day's plan? What's your week's plan? What's your month's plan? What's your life's plan? And obviously, there are no guarantees, nor do I suggest that there will ever be. But as I mentioned before, if you plan, you prepare, and you're in the race, you're going to finish the race. And the only time, again, that you're not going to finish is if you're not in it. Prepare, plan, move forward, be the best you possibly can be. And so that gets me to number six, which is persistence. You know, the fact is that, of course, you've heard over and over from the time when you were children. And that is, if at first you don't succeed, what do? You try again. The fact is that, you know, the measure of a person is not that they trip, it's not that they stumble, it's not that they fall. All of us throughout this beautiful life that we live, perhaps we will stumble. Perhaps we will trip, and yes, perhaps we'll fall. It's a part of what we go through. It's a part of life. But the measure of a person is not that they tripped, not that they stumbled, nor that they fell. It's that they have the ability to brush themselves off, to keep it moving, to get up, and to try anew. And the only way you can do that is by being persistent. You know, all of you are here today because of that very persistence. You're here because of the fact that you worked hard, you did what you needed to do. And guess what? I'm looking at you right now. And you are about to cross this stage to be conferred your degree. And that degree is in no small measure based upon what you have inside of you and the persistence that you carried out every single day to bring you to this moment. And for that, you owe yourself a debt of gratitude. And the same thing that you carried forward that allowed you to graduate today is the same persistence that you need to continue to work with to carry you through the next day, the next month, the next year, and for the rest of your life. And then I look at number seven, which is panic. And the fact is that maybe, and we all have had occasion where things don't work out, and so we might panic. And so you didn't get the job that you really wanted to get. You didn't get the promotion you think you deserved. You stay ready, you stay focused. You didn't get the job, you interview for another one. The fact is that you want to build a business and the business doesn't work out, you develop another business, you keep moving, but you don't panic. Because the issue with any problem that we may encounter in life is what a fabulous thing a problem is. And you say, well, how can I say a problem is a fabulous thing? Because it gives us an opportunity to create and to find a solution. And I'm sure all of you out there, as you're listening, you've had problems. But you know what? Apparently, you've come up with quite a solution. Because guess what? You're graduating today. And so the fact is we don't panic. Because when we panic, we don't have our sensibilities about us. But we can tread water because we use smooth strokes. And we also swim to the other side because of those smooth strokes. You have made it to the other side. You are now graduates of the college at Brockport. That's huge. Now, that brings me to P number eight, and that is the past. And the fact is that you've heard it before, yesterday is history, tomorrow remains a mystery. And so what do? We live for today, the here and now. The fact is that whatever happened yesterday, whatever happened today, a bad morning doesn't make a bad afternoon, a bad afternoon doesn't make a bad evening, and a bad evening absolutely doesn't make a bad night. If something happened this morning, the day before, the week before, the month before, the year before, let it go. If everything worked out great yesterday, that's great. Continue to work, continue to get better, continue to be better, continue to do better. But we're at our best when we don't rely upon or live in the past, but when we capture today and build for a better tomorrow. And so that leads me to number 9, which is positivity. And the fact is that there's something about being positive that just really brings us the energy we need to make it through and to get through. If we're gonna believe, if we're gonna will it, we have to live it. If we're gonna walk the walk and talk the talk, we have to really believe in ourselves and know we can do it. And there's something about positivity that just wills a better day, a better future, a better tomorrow. If you ever see people yawn, what happens is it's almost contagious. You begin yawning too. Same thing with positive energy. You stay positive, you stay focused, you stay in believing that you can do whatever it is that you put your mind to doing, and guess what? Sooner or later, you end up at the Special Events Recreation Center at the College of Brockport in 2016, and you get to walk across this stage, and that's because of your positive energy and all the work and the commitment that you've done that have brought you to this day. Stay positive throughout your lives, and that same positivity that brought you to graduation day will carry over in your life and pay dividends in tremendous ways. And so finally, I leave you with P10. And P10 relates to something that's very important, and that is paying it forward. You know, each of us has a responsibility, an obligation to help someone, to mentor someone, to care for someone, to uplift someone, and to share special knowledge that we have with someone else. Why? Because it's the right thing to do. You know, karma is a wonderful thing, and karma allows us to get the universe's energy, if you will, through the good deeds that we do. But we don't pay it forward for that reason. We pay it forward because it's humane, because it's responsible, and because it just feels right. And so always remember, if you get to a place where you can help somebody else, do so. We live in a world that needs a lot of help. We live in a world that needs everybody's ability, everybody's talent to pull forward. A person does not have to fail in order for us to succeed. There's room aplenty for great ideas, for great people, for great workers, for great businesses. And that comes because we uplift our brothers, we uplift our sisters, and we uplift people in need. And so concluding with my P's, let me tell you that it is my privilege to appear before you and to share time with you on this great afternoon. And I will tell you that if you continue to pay it forward, you stay passionate, you stay positive, you stay prepared, you plan, there will be nothing in this world that you can't accomplish and nothing that you can do. Persist, endure, be the best version of yourself, and I'm so fortunate and thankful to have a moment to spend with you. God bless you, class of 2016.
That was truly inspirational. Let's give him another round of applause.
Will the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Nursing please rise? That's all of you. President McPherson, each of these candidates has completed or is completing the course of study prescribed by the faculty and approved by the Board of Regents. I present them to you with the recommendation that you confer upon each the degrees earned upon satisfactory completion of all the requirements thereto.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the trustees of the State University of New York, upon your completion of all requirements, I confer upon you Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Nursing with all of the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Let's have a round of applause. Please be seated. We will now recognize the students individually. We ask that everyone in the audience please remain seated and hold your applause until all of the students have been recognized. Students will be asked to come forward by rows to have their names read. Please remain seated until your row is directed to the platform.
Hang tight. Hold on. Now approaching the stage are the candidates from the School of the Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences. Maddie Kuhar.
Felicia Heidemann.
Ashley Golly.
Benjamin Falter.
Lindsay Selvis.
Nicholas Green.
Annabelle McDonald.
James Arnold.
Megan Teft.
Nicole Polisny.
Shane Oswita.
Nicole Swarout.
Aka Miles. Bailey Lintner. Chelsea Bentley. Michael Thurston. Lindsay Snyder. Julie Swenson.
Matthew Alexander.
Austin Scott.
Heather Gagnon.
Ronika Burns. Brooke Love.
Bethany Fry.
Natalia Monhertz.
Haley Plymo.
Christina Warney.
Daniel Duval.
Chanel Martin.
Marielle Brinkerhoff.
Nicole Wheeler.
Tess Dumont.
Chris Rawlinson.
Frank Kiofetlasi.
Maxwell Batty.
So Nguyen.
Craig Cusano.
Elizabeth Seitz.
Darren Plunkett.
Jacqueline Myers.
Dominique Bowler.
Jacqueline Myers.
Brianna Maslin.
Sarah Hall.
Sean Flynn.
Emily Deeb.
Kimberly Taylor.
Clarice Asher.
Jessica Rivera Stuckwell.
Casey Capoletti.
Magalis Rivera.
Lindsay Artis.
Saray Adams.
Caitlin Swentek.
Janae Williams.
Brandon Groth.
Mason Banizek.
Megan Dygert.
Aaliyah Fowler.
Megan Wondersee.
Caitlin Allen.
Jennifer Montfort.
Brianna Parker.
Haley Camilleri.
Shaying Jen.
Patricia Brown.
Alexander Tosto.
Gabrielle Fontana.
Quinn Cohut.
Miranda Thompson.
Carly Sober.
Stephanie Brangen.
Rebecca Snow. Shannon Van Valkenburg.
Samantha Halifax.
Richmond Beaubriant.
Sierra Nick Andre.
Nathan Doherty.
Veronica Stamp.
Abigail Baker.
Derek Van Orman.
Michael Schwartz.
Rachel Mavahill.
Dylan Muller.
Mary Grace Kabalski.
Abigail Rice.
Rebecca Dickerson.
Marielle Rivera.
Jessica Archer.
Michelle Hatch.
Nicole Kursup.
David Palmer.
Jessica Williamson.
Alicia Poshadley.
Sarah Connor.
Nicholas Costello.
Robin Wohlers.
Cody LeClaire. Cody LeClaire.
Wataru Arihara.
Tyler Burgett.
Joshua Colon.
Grant Pastori. Yeah.
Christopher Gincursio.
Joshua Lucas Laskowski.
Mason Pell.
Lauren Tracy.
Chelsea Maxson.
Alex Mulroy.
Christopher Shea.
Rebecca Jeffords.
Lauren McKeon.
Judy Fixler.
Krista Seeley.
Darius Favors.
Ashley Grant.
Jonathan Kingsley.
Katherine Heinzelman.
Nikki Small.
Carrie Donnelly.
Caitlin Foster.
Melissa Anweiler.
Andrew Davidson.
Kezia Harrison.
Ryan Smith.
Kayla Marie Candela.
Brianna Morlock.
Danny Joram.
Alicia Clark.
Michaela Seno.
Nala Ward.
Nicholas J. Abreu.
Priscilla Bain.
Brody Anguinjota.
Sean Kirkoba.
Morgan Bowman.
Elizabeth Merritt.
Peter Borges.
Adam Sidor.
Whitney Whitfield.
Efren DeJesus.
Marilyn Mosher.
Anthony Matella Jr.
Bradley LaPlante.
Connor Wolf.
Gage Grushaw.
Jacob Domes.
Daniel Martucci.
John Fakowski.
Julia Yepes.
Ryan Patton.
Talia Mocario.
Natalie Gill.
Faith Fletcher.
Vanessa Way.
Ashley Owens.
Cheryl Sampson.
Thomas Carpetella.
Emily Huesinger.
Jessica Boder.
James Fontanez.
Evan Dressel.
Richard Lung.
Ayana Britt.
Elizabeth Hoke.
Olivia Petit.
Jenna Skinner.
Alexandra Metcalf.
Kendall Schneider.
Ryan Carney.
Munar Marini.
Marissa Coelho.
Kelsey Abdo.
Amanda Pikulski.
Catherine Nesbitt.
Catherine Taylor.
Taylor Dixon.
Susan Foote.
Daniel Alexander.
Liz Bailey.
Michael Zazzo.
Emily Burkhard.
Andrew Gill.
Laura Vanzetta.
April Johnson Haygood.
Sarah Bird.
Brooke Hoppler.
Brooke White.
Gregory Gina.
Bridget Chartraw.
Wanzi Gomez.
Couldn't read his writing.
Daniel Spaltai.
Dylan Coletta.
Timothy Latina.
Stephanie Shaluga.
Patrick Monahan.
Dallas Armentano.
Sarah LaQuitara.
Leanne Marie Nagel.
Richard Reisinger.
Brianna Walker.
Evan Kern.
Skylar Bell.
Sean McAndrew.
Emily Copeland.
Matthew Schrader.
Nicole Grigonis.
Jordan Summer.
Sarah Ilardo.
Aaron Sawicki.
Jordan Demetrius Lloyd.
Thomas Joseph Fornarola.
Marissa Subic.
Jonathan J.T. White.
Bailey Capri Simpson.
Brandon Dixon.
Abby Lorena Stabel.
Tyler Brown.
Emily Gerst.
Erica Neuberger.
Lene Dupre.
Alexander Pierce.
Kimberly Souls.
Michael Saracini.
Jessica DeSalvia.
William Battaglia.
Olivia Howard.
Michael Oden.
Melissa Froats.
Samantha Dolly.
Sarah Palmisano.
Derek Richmond.
Lexi Hills.
Nick Caprielli.
Elisa Darrow.
Matthew Rogers.
Tanya Murphy.
Melissa Gonzalez.
Megan Amadin.
Takia Aldgladden.
Jared Barge.
Nita Marie Herbert.
Logan Raybuck.
Ricardo Scherzer Smith.
Jacqueline Baker.
Brittany Chenise Brissarda.
Hannah Schneeberger.
Shanique Harden.
Mackenzie Grosso.
Melvin Lloyd.
Matthew Seltzer.
Austin Smith.
Zachary Robinson.
Lindsay Abbott.
John Watson.
Miranda Sambuki.
Christopher Rowland.
Joseph Larkin.
Sally Koenig.
Larissa Diaz.
Skylar Shaw.
Sierra Caruso.
Alexis Russo.
Lindsay Wokelwerch.
Cody Kaminska.
Sarah Toby.
Heather Leary.
Brenna Carol Donegan.
Ashley Eck.
Shannon Bossinger.
Matthew DeLuca.
Jessica Riggio.
Randy Crenshaw.
Jonathan Pratt.
Robert Miller.
Alexandria Winslow.
Joshua Matula.
Michael Boddy.
John Behringer. Zachary Kilmer.
Whitney Ray White.
Carly Schmidt.
Jasmine Coley.
Gregory Schmidt.
Maya Smith.
Catherine Nye.
Brianna Smith.
Alexandra Linke.
Sabrina Smith.
Sarah Kelzek.
Chester Arthur Johnson III.
Kelly O'Connell.
Caitlin Blake.
Marcella Brisson.
Ramel Holiday.
Ashley Caleb.
Philip Kenneth Karch.
Margaret Huntoon.
Stefan Friedrich.
Emily Lauren.
Nolan Avery.
Barbara Way.
Nicholas Feligno. Sam Tanner. Sean Flagging. Kevin Murdoch. Daniel Phillips. Peter Gottfried. Gregory Elias. Ian Christopher Clytus. Joshua Gagnon. Adam Capello. Matthew Dean.
Now approaching the stage are the candidates from the School of Business Administration and Economics. Dawn Marie Footer.
Jacob Jackson.
Emily Ball.
Alex Conway.
Timothy Pizarro.
Alexandra Bennett.
Mike O'Connell.
Kelly Schoniker.
Christopher Kenneth Gartley.
Jake Roth.
Joseph Creel.
Courtney Ryan.
I love how she does it.
Elizabeth Dates.
Deanna Boyani.
Daniel Gehringer.
Joseph Fay.
Erie Sugeno.
Brian Draghi.
Adnu Wasihan.
Tyler Zay.
Christina Crespo.
Patrick Bronchidal.
Timothy Daniels.
Gavin Theofield.
Elena Cross.
Nicholas Campy.
Petronelle Mukajimenti.
Charles Pace.
Is that right? Oh my God. Yes.
Sang Kim.
Vanessa Paradise Namba.
Michael Gallagher.
Nadagi Kalumbi.
Eric Cunningham.
Kentu Matsuda.
Stefan Ruck.
Mohammed Aiden.
Hakeem Ture.
Teresita Dowd.
Joseph Lividny III.
Frankie Davoli.
Matthew Marola.
Colin Dombeck.
William Thompson.
Brandon Hyman.
Justin Condello.
Michael Incardona, Christy Stone, Damian Creta,
Chelsea Rackmeyer,
Shannon Broderick,
Malia Frederick,
Jeffrey Kilgore,
Erica Klein,
Amina Molly,
Sarah Millay,
Melinda Hygen,
Keith Garrett,
Michelle Kukovoka,
Priyane Patel,
Ellen Manella,
Zachary Blum,
Sonata Smajic,
Lisa M. Bianco,
Craig Rugari,
Chelsea Donnelly,
Caitlin Brink,
Caitlin Schicker,
Nicole Sands,
Lauren Frank,
Lee Tron,
Joshua Correa,
Ayana Sinclair,
Noah Bixby,
Rena Sherman,
Crystal Austin,
Kim Merzinski,
Anna Boring,
Rachel Selena,
Jesse Miller,
Chloe Perry,
Miguel Angel Martinez,
Aralee Hyman,
Tra Tran,
Juan Delgado,
Yu Wong Zhang,
Michael Tao,
Dylan Haas,
Marshall Scheid,
Rachel D'Ambrosia,
Corbin Pominville,
Dominic Guglielmo,
Brendan Kinsella,
Rachel Smith,
Edward S. Suriano,
Alexa Arena,
Mark Henry,
I love you, Grandma.
Gina Papino,
Adam Christ,
Timothy Dreis,
Raymond McAlpin,
Samantha McCune,
Jeffrey Schiallo,
Christopher Apera,
Cole Tristam,
Lamique Gerald,
Joshua Braben,
George Doherty,
Justin Kittle,
Andrew Troop,
Janelle Draper,
Matthew Brickle,
Elaine Allen,
Alden Manjovich,
Morgan Smith,
Nathan Devers,
Emily Judge,
Nathan Roman,
Jessica Sutton,
Shoshana Fox,
Sabrina Camilleri,
Giovanna Palmieri,
Lauren Spear,
Christina Sobzak,
Danica Hendricks,
Megan Gorenflow,
Daniel Fitzmaurice,
Quinn Roberts Major,
Michael Finkelstein,
Kelsey Gerard,
Eric Lodico,
Crystal Alvarez,
Michael Pendergast,
Brian Benjamin,
Connor Briggs,
Heather Marie Prinsen,
Christopher Miller,
Louis Silva,
Robert Negron,
Philip Brindamore,
Jacob Randolph,
Samuel Camellio,
Nicholas Zarconi,
Cameron Shaughnessy,
Heather Pierce,
Christopher Demchenko,
Brandon Penskin,
Justin Godnier,
Zachary Tanner,
Aaron Foreman,
John David Reagan,
Nicholas J. Pappas.
Elizabeth Schotnick.
Jack Conley.
Joseph David Evershed.
Michael Kavecchia.
Mark Hoslip.
Aaron Hahn.
Colby Kramer.
Abraham Reinhardt.
Nicholas Dizel.
Alex Rivera.
Shane Curry.
Cody Detoy.
Matthew Doty.
Alyssa Barna.
Natasha Arnold.
Zachary Doble.
Alexa Crescent.
Zachary Steger.
John Doan.
Lauren Stitch.
Jesse Faccini. Jared Lockhurst. Marcus Farmer. James Ryan. Faria Kadari. Christina Rose Moraza. Robert Berger. Quentin Tarbox.
Okay, let me have some water real quick. 1 second.
Now approaching the stage are the candidates from the School of Education and Human Services. Dannon DeLockey.
Amelia Garcia.
Catherine Carr.
Nicole Goff.
Taylor Doty.
Matt Duendala.
Yasiel Sanchez.
Dave Bianchi.
Arlene Perez.
Seth Welch.
Diana Perla.
Landon Alvarado.
Anthony Bartolucci.
Aaron Fleming.
David Almy.
Jillian Trader.
Ryan Walsh.
Kaylee Treyer.
Isaac Taylor.
Grace Roberts.
Travis Ahrens.
Bailey Reed.
Seamus Harvey.
Jeffrey Prouse.
Matthew Del Broco.
Joshua Appel.
Olivia Sir.
Wesley Burkhart.
Sarah Reddington.
Kevin Harmon.
Zach Leswing.
Joshua Martin.
Catherine Free.
Danielle Wessis.
Andrew Rice.
Timothy Seagrew.
Devin Vanderzee.
Brett Sanders.
Deanna Kessler.
Danielle Peck.
Jacqueline Ryan.
Charisse Miller.
David Murphy.
Derek Farah.
Brett Brisky.
Kevin Schoonmaker.
Andrew Hooten.
David Loomis.
Clifton Jackson.
Shakisha Cray.
Derek Foster.
Brian Noble Cavill.
Jesse Dreyer.
Brian Alsever.
Amanda Falsey.
Gregory Indick.
Natasha Hale.
Megan Ferry.
Morgan Simmons.
Gina Leggett.
Chuck McDonald.
Whitley Stefaniak.
Estelle D'Acquisto.
Megan Chitty.
Melissa Rohr.
Vernita Peet.
Carly Warner.
Jacob Callen.
Rachel Hazel.
Ben Cooper.
Crystal Laird.
Jade McEnroot.
Emily Bucci.
Caitlin Popolars.
Kimberly Miller.
Megan Christopher.
Taylor Morehouse.
Shannon O'Connor.
Courtney Canfield.
Lila Zev Verstreet.
Cheyenne Bela.
Marissa McTruck.
Leah Grace Staley.
Maria Garcia.
Ryan Hall.
Selena Kirk.
David Ford.
Story Post.
Lucine Belitti.
Catherine Kibler.
Abu Belitti.
Allie Burns.
Genesis Arios.
Nicole Finelli.
Chanel Watt.
Amber Masita.
Nicole Nachai.
Ashley Ostrander.
Tyler Walker.
Aaron Bork.
Troy Myers.
Marina Ba.
Corinne Stephanie McLaughlin.
Yubinesh Kebedi.
Catherine Garten Park.
Kelly Alvarez.
Chelsea Stamm.
Carlene Conrad.
Amanda Pittinger.
Jenna Kent.
Cassandra Cruz.
Jessica Zelazny.
Cassandra Nicole Klopfel.
Debbie Morgan Cummings.
Micah Watt Woodworth.
Veronica Lenhart.
Sarah Lee.
Jessica Nyhoff.
Lisa Rates.
Shatara Jones.
Lori Johnson.
Catherine Liebel.
Matthew Sherwood.
Rebecca Holmes.
Tatiana Sanders.
James Babcock.
Brandon Keller.
Kevin J. Sims.
Carl Baker.
Dean Papura.
Ronald Smith. Julie Whalen. Hannah Arlington. Casey Rue. Alexandria Disk. And our last but not least best graduate, Krishna Dent.
Wasn't that powerful? First off, I want to say how proud I am of everyone here that just graduated. It's been a long road to get here, but we finally did it. We're finally within a mile of home. My name is Nick Green, and I am here representing the senior class. First, I would like to thank all of my classmates for their participation and generosity with the Make Your Mark Senior Class Giving Campaign. I hope as alumni you will all continue to give back and support this place that has done so much for us over the past few years. I would also like to announce that the School of Science and Mathematics had the highest level of senior participation and therefore won the Senior Cup. I hear this morning Joe's actually jumped out of his seat when he heard about it. President McPherson, it is my distinct privilege to present this check to the College at Brockport for $5,000 on behalf of the class of 2016.
Thank you, Nick. Thank you to the members of the class of 2016 who contributed to this gift. This contribution will help future students achieve the same goals that the class of 2016 achieved today. And this is the biggest gift we've had for quite some time, so I think that deserves another round of applause. Thank you. It's now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Sean Flynn, the Brockport Student Government President.
Hello, I'm Sean Flynn, president of the Brockport Student Government, for about five more minutes. There was an extraordinary presence when she took the stage, a level of sincerity that could only be accomplished by someone who had witnessed immense suffering in their lifetime. She spoke to the crowd. I choose to give love, to be loving. These are the words of Liz Murray. Liz was our keynote speaker at the October Diversity Conference hosted here at the College of Brockport. To understand Liz Murray, you have to understand adversity. She grew up in a household where her parents suffered from addiction. Both their parents were completely unable to care for her and provide for her the necessities of life. Two parents that did love her but couldn't show it through their actions. And Liz ended up homeless by the time she was a teenager. She described that when she reached this state of poverty, she really had to think about what her life would mean. What was her purpose? And she found it within herself to go back to school, devote all her time to learning everything she had missed out on, and eventually she applied to college. She ended up getting a full ride to Harvard, where she was very successful, and she has since then written and published her own book. From homeless to Harvard? Her story is one of incredible perseverance. And when I heard that Liz was going to be our keynote speaker, I was intrigued. Although, in the back of my mind, I was a little worried. From homeless to Harvard, I mean, man, that transition's gonna take someone really intelligent, like beautiful mind, Russell Crowe type of intelligence, you know? I was worried this Liz Murray was gonna come up there with a 50-page outline and start speaking in calculus to us. I was worried she wasn't gonna be relatable, but I was totally, totally wrong. I was blown away by her speech and by her presence. Above all, she wanted us to choose love. It was so important to her. She spoke about how much she adored her parents, that even disabled by drug abuse, she could still tell that they cared so deeply for her. The drugs had become a disease, one that left her parents unable to survive. But their love for her was a choice for which she was forever grateful. She asked us as an audience in a reflective way, how much do we hold that back? How much do we hold our love back? And I really had to think about that. We are in a room right now full of people who refuse to hold their love back for us. And we are the manifestation of that love. This moment represents so much more than our own accomplishments. It represents our friends, our family, our professors, and all those who have cared for us unconditionally. So today, and every day of your life, I encourage you to choose love and don't hold it back. We have one word for love in the English language. The Italians have like 67. We've got one word, and I think it's a shame that as a society, we shelter it when we speak to one another. We waste it on silly things like food. I love blueberry Pop-Tarts, and I do very much love blueberry Pop-Tarts. But when was the last time we told our friends that we love them, that we actually love them? You're allowed to use that word when referring to your friends, your professors, your family. I love you. Thank you for believing in me. Thank you for being an inspiration. When we bust out of this room, diploma in hand, rushing off to the next page in our story, the world will be waiting. A world of new passions, new experiences, new people, ready to encapsulate us in our future. It is massive, and it is scary, and none of us know exactly what the next chapter will bring. It's okay to feel lost. Thousands of moments will string together like words on a page, and each moment will be written in permanent ink. There's no erasing what happens next. But don't forget, you're the author. You choose what is written. I'll leave you with one last quote from Liz. Don't expect anything. Everything is a blessing. Everything is a gift. Thank you. As the 2015-2016 president of the Brockport Student Government, I present to the Brockport Alumni Association the graduating class of 2016.
Thank you, Sean. I accept this class on behalf of the Brockport Alumni Association as our newest alumni and members for life in the College of Brockport Alumni Association. These past years are just the beginning of your association with your alma mater. We invite you to visit often, contribute regularly, either monetarily or by mentoring a future Brockport student, and stay in touch for your online alumni newsletter. At this time, will all of this year's graduating class of 2016 please rise? It is, as the president of the Brockport Alumni Association, it is my honor to lead you in a tangible gesture which symbolizes your passage from the status of undergraduates to the ranks of graduates and alumni of the College at Brockport. Please move the tassel on your cap from the right side to the left side. Congratulations. Welcome new alumni for the College at Brockport. Please be seated. Sorry.
As we conclude, let me offer my personal congratulations to each and every graduate. We are proud of your accomplishments. Let me also recognize our staff who work tirelessly each day to ensure that your experience at the college is the best that it can be. And to our faculty, thank you. Thank you not only for being here today, but for what you do each and every day to help each student realize his or her capacity for intellectual, physical, and creative accomplishment. Your enthusiasm for and dedication and commitment to student success is a hallmark of a Brockport education. I am proud to be associated with such a talented group of scholars. Let's give a hand for the staff and faculty. We encourage all family members and guests to meet their graduate at the reception in the Tuttle North Gymnasiums following the recessional. Our reception is a wonderful opportunity for our graduates and their family and friends to meet the faculty and staff they have come to know during their Brockport journey. I ask that our graduates and guests remain at their seats until the platform party and faculty have recessed. Students, once the platform party and faculty have recessed, the marshals and volunteers will guide you out of the field house. I hereby declare the 2016 commencement ceremony of the College at Brockport, State University of New York, to be concluded. Congratulations, it's official.
Thank you.
As a reminder, the students will formally recess. We ask that you please remain in your seats until the platform party, faculty, and students have recessed before you leave to meet your new graduate. Graduates, their families, and guests are invited to join the faculty and staff at a reception in the graduate's honor. It will be held immediately following the conclusion of the recessional in Tuttle North Gyms 205 and 206. Once again, congratulations to our newest alumni. We thank you for attending today's commencement exercise, and please enjoy the rest of your day at the College of Brockport.